then I think actually the news media was really helpful, and your station in particular, in uncovering this particular scheme.
New at 6, three men arrested, sentenced, I should say, to spend time in federal prison for a mortgage fraud scheme uncovered by a KCRA3 investigation. It's a crime that Judge Edward Garcia says ruined victims' credit and closed financial institutions. Good evening, I'm Kelly McMullen.
And I'm Gulston Dart. 6 years after being exposed, the leaders of this financial scheme are going to federal prison.
Mr. Martin, any thoughts on the sentence at all? Anything to say?
James Martin and Mario Fellini said nothing on their way out of federal court today after being sentenced to federal prison for bank fraud and money laundering. Their ringleader, Gabriel Viramontes, is already in custody. Martin and Fellini have until April to turn themselves in to U.S. Marshals.
At first, we hid behind our lawyers.
Much different than just a few years ago when James Martin admitted to KCRA3 that he falsified mortgage applications.
I admit that there's illegal activity.
The three men founded VFM Investments, convincing investors to purchase dozens of homes worth millions of dollars in the hopes that renters would move in.
Please search warrant, open the door.
All of this came to a head when federal agents raided VFM's offices and the home of Gabriel Viramontes, seen here in handcuffs and on his knees in front of his house. The raids happened just 3 weeks after KCRA3 exposed Viramontes, Martins, and Fellini's mortgage fraud scheme.
How much did they say you were making?
About $14,000 a month.
Tim McDaniels, one of those investors, VFM inflated his income and the value of the homes in order to make hundreds of thousands in commissions.
All of us had to file bankruptcy, all seven of us, and that's 7 years. And they got less than 7 years. That's what's a little disheartening about the whole case.
Viramontes, the ringleader, will spend just under 5 years in jail. Martin, 20 months. And Fellini, 6 months in jail, 5 months in home confinement.
We're very pleased with how the sentencing went.
Assistant U.S. Attorney Michael Anderson says the sentences today show how serious the government is taking these crimes, particularly in how the damage goes beyond mere investors.
When you put together all the types of schemes that were going on, many institutions have gone under since then, including some of the institutions involved in this case.
The hearing will be held in the next 60 days so investors can make claims to get some of the money back from the men convicted in this case.